Hello and welcome back to this Machine Learning and AI for Beginners video series. In previous videos, we showed how you can use Azure AI services to build AI applications. Now, these AI services and those examples showed pre-trained models. In this video, we're going to get into how you can train custom models using Azure AI services for specialized use cases using your data. Now, in this video, we're going to take a look at why you might want to train these models. And then we're going to go into a demo of how you can actually train custom models, again, using your own data with Azure AI services. So why train a custom model, right? Well, it really comes down to customization. So the pre-trained models, they don't really have knowledge about your data, your domain, your use case, right? They were trained on fairly generic data that's representative and pretty much works really well across a wide variety of general scenarios. However, again, if in your enterprise, in your industry, in your particular company, right, there are specialized use cases for this, to use these models under, right? That's when you might want to start considering training these models using your own data and customizing them. Right. And then in doing so, right, you're going to be able to go beyond these sort of more general scenarios and really make these models your own, right? So not only is it going to provide more efficient responses in terms that it's going to, you know, provide relevant responses, as we saw in previous videos, but the efficiency really comes down to the fact that because you are committing some of this information to memory, right, or at least the memory of this model, right, you're able to more quickly or efficiently retrieve responses. Sort of an example that I'll sort of give here is, imagine that you want to go to a new place, right? And so the way that you probably might go about that is you might use some sort of navigation device or your phone to navigate there. So you pull out your navigation device, you enter the address, and then you sort of follow instructions as to how to get to your destination, right? Now let's imagine that you do that periodically, right? And you start doing that over and over again. Now you can continue entering the address, pulling out the navigation device, and following those directions, right? And you're going to end up at your destination. However, if you commit those to memory, right, all of a sudden, you've sort of taken a few steps out of that process, and you can just get in your car or, you know, public transportation or start walking, and you can get to your destination quicker, right, without having to go through the process of entering data into your navigation device. Right. So you can think of it similarly this way, where by providing your own data, right, you're helping these models learn about your domain, learn about your system, and really truly making it your own. Right? So before we get into the sample and the demos, let me just remind you that you can find the code for this video over at the aka.ms/.net-ai-beginner. Let's take a look at some code. So if we take a look at this sample, essentially, what we're going to be doing here is we're going to be training a custom model with AI services. Specifically, we're going to be using the custom vision service to take images or create an image classifier to identify cracked and uncracked pavements. So you may see that the images that have cracks very clearly have a crack in them, and the uncracked images have no cracks, right? And so we want to be able to have sort of this model that we're going to customize and build upon, try to determine whether a piece of concrete is cracked or uncracked. You might imagine this being useful sort of in sort of infrastructure inspections and those fields, right? So the way that we do that is we start off here with installing NuGet packages in this case, it's the custom vision training and prediction NuGet packages. We then go ahead and add our using statements. We get our credentials from our environment variables for both training and prediction services. And then we sort of create a set of utility functions just to list our projects and any tags that exist there, right? At this point, we go ahead and configure our training client. So before we can use these models, we're going to have to train them using our own data. And so that's what we are initializing this custom vision training client here. At that point, we go ahead and we create a project called Infrastructure CV Project, right? And once we've created our project, we want to make sure that we create tags or labels or categories for each of the individual images that we're going to classify. And in this case, we have two sets of images or two labels. We have cracked and uncracked. Okay. And then all this is doing is it's using that training client to create the individual tags respectively for cracked and uncracked. Once that's done, it's time to upload our data, right? We need data to be able to train and customize this model. So the data looks very similar to the one that was sort of shown here, right? So we have a whole bunch of images that have examples of cracked, and we have a bunch of images with uncracked samples here, okay? So we're gonna go ahead and get that from our local directory here, and then we're gonna go through each of those sets of images, the cracked and the uncracked, and upload those to Azure. Once we have those images in Azure, we're gonna call train project here using our training client. And this is just gonna take a few minutes here. You can see here it took about 4 minutes to go through the training process of customizing this vision model for our particular use case. Once we're happy with this model, we can go ahead and publish it. And we're gonna publish it under the name of infrastructure classifier model, right? And that's just gonna create a version inside of the custom vision service for us. And then finally, once that service and that model is published to our project, we're gonna wanna test out the model and see whether it actually is able to categorize images as, you know, cracked or uncracked pavement. And so what we do is we configure this custom vision prediction client, right, using the credentials that we sort of registered earlier. And then we're gonna grab from the cracked image paths, we're gonna grab the first one here, right? And so we know that this is a cracked image. So what we would expect here is that the prediction will come back with a classification or a label saying that this image is a cracked image, okay? So we're gonna call classify image async on our prediction client here to generate a prediction. And once we inspect that, we can see the value of that comes back as cracked here, right? So it would apply the tag of cracked. And then the probability of one, meaning that it's highly confident that this in fact is a cracked image, okay? In this video, we took a look at how you can use Azure AI services like Custom Vision to train custom AI models that fit specialized use cases. We went over why you might want to train these models, and then we showed a few samples and demonstrations of how you can train a custom model using Azure AI services. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.